morning students. Now our today's lecture will be development of superior vena cava. In order to understand the development of superior vena cava, it is important, essential to understand the development of the somatic veins. Those are cardinal veins. So one vein which comes in play here will be anterior cardinal vein. Now this anterior cardinal vein will in short develop into superior vena cava, but it is a long process. Therefore, now here we start with the anterior cardinal vein in such a way that initially first we draw the flexors, primitive flexors of the brain. Now these are the primitive flexors of the brain, and there are three primitive flexors of the brain. Now here neural tube, these are the flexors in which we have the forebrain, prosencephalic flexure, this is mesencephalic flexure midbrain, and this is rhombencephalic flexure, which will be metencephalon and myelencephalon. Later on, during development of neural tube, during the development of nervous system, this will be taught or discussed with you in detail. Right now, here, this is the entire neural tube. These are the three primitive brain vesicles. The three primitive brain vesicles, forebrain, midbrain, hindbrain, rhombencephalon, and the continuation of the neural tube as spinal cord. Here, at this level, there will be formation of trigeminal ganglion. Now, this is what we have to show. This will be the trigeminal ganglion only. Trigeminal ganglion. Now, we start with the cardinal veins. We know that there are two common cardinal veins which will open in the either side of sinus venosus. The anterior cardinal vein is going to draw the blood. It will drain the blood from the head and neck region, that is the brain region, and the side of the neck and upper limb. So therefore, from above, that anterior cardinal vein is going to drain the blood into the common cardinal vein. Now, this anterior cardinal vein is divided into two parts, cephalic and cervicothoracic. So here, the two parts will be, number one, cephalic part, that will be known as the primary head vein. Now this word is very important. Primary head vein, which is present in the cephalic direction, in the cranial direction. And second vein will be cervicothoracic vein. So therefore, these two veins are anterior cardinal veins only. So initially in the development, anterior cardinal vein, the vein which will drain the blood from the brain will be known as the primary head vein, also head region. And the vein which is present in the thoracic region, it is called cervicothoracic region, cervicothoracic vein. So therefore, the anterior cardinal vein will extend in the head region, that is where the neural tube is developing, on either side of neural tube as primary head vein. So this primary head vein now will lie posterolateral to the neural tube on both the sides of neural tube. So here I will draw this primary head vein. See here, this is the primary head vein which is passing. So therefore, this primary head vein will lie medial to trigeminal ganglion. Please note down, it will lie medial to trigeminal ganglion. This region is very important. So here I will put some dots. Therefore, primary head vein lying on the lateral side of neural tube, on this side as well as on that side, but it will lie medial to trigeminal ganglion of both the sides, right and left. Therefore, now this primary head vein will drain the blood from venous plexus, which will develop now in the region of forebrain, in the region of midbrain, in the region of hindbrain. So therefore, there will be various venous plexuses. These are the venous plexuses in forebrain, midbrain, as well as hindbrain. Now these venous plexuses will divide into two groups. Note down, it will divide into two groups because of the development of meninges. The meninges of the brain will develop here. As the meninges will develop, as it will differentiate, the venous plexus will divide into two groups, superficial and deep. And what are those two groups, superficial and deep? For example, here I will make the superficial group. These are the superficial group, and these superficial group will be known as, they will develop later on into the venous sinuses. What about the deep? The deep group which will be located, the deep group which will be located will develop into cerebral veins. So therefore, from these venous plexuses, there will be drainage of blood into the primary head vein. So therefore, three veins will drain the blood from all these venous plexuses. Now, cerebral veins which have developed from the deep veins and dural venous sinuses which have developed from the superficial veins, they will drain the blood into primary head vein. Therefore, now we start with the, supposing this is the primary head vein. Here, this primary head vein will drain the blood from prosencephalon and mesencephalon, that is from forebrain and midbrain. Dural venous sinuses which are present in the forebrain, dural venous sinuses which are present in the mesencephalon midbrain is drained by the vein which is known as anterior dural stem. So therefore, this vein will be known as, now here this vein will be known as anterior dural stem. And all these plexuses, they are known as venous plexuses. And all these venous plexuses are divided into superficial and deep. So only we mark here the dural venous sinuses initially, which develop from the same venous plexus but from the superficial part of venous plexus. Now, anterior dural stem is the vein which is draining from these dural venous sinuses or venous plexuses of the forebrain and midbrain. Second, middle dural stem. This middle dural stem will drain the blood. See here, it is going to drain the blood from, it is going to drain the blood from the part of rhombencephalon. Now that part of rhombencephalon is known as metencephalon. So here I will write simply metencephalon. And the vein which is draining here, this vein, I will name it as the middle dural stem, draining the blood from venous plexus of the metencephalon. And last one, we have finished anterior dural stem, we have finished middle dural stem. Now the last one, posterior dural stem. Now posterior dural stem, this is the vein which will drain here, and this posterior dural stem will be draining the blood from myelencephalon. So here this portion of the rhombencephalon will be known as myelencephalon. So whatever venous sinuses, whatever venous channels, venous plexuses are located in myelencephalon, which will later on develop into medulla oblongata. From that myelencephalon, the posterior dural vein will drain the blood into primary head vein. So here I will mark this as posterior dural stem. So now we have the three dural stems: anterior dural stem, middle dural stem, posterior dural stem, draining the blood from the venous plexuses of the neural tube into the primary head vein. So now we name this structure as the primary head vein. Here we name this structure as the primary head vein. Note down this. Here we have finished the first stage: anterior dural stem, middle dural stem, posterior dural stem, draining the blood from these venous plexuses into the primary head vein. What is primary head vein? The cranial, the cephalic continuation of anterior cardinal vein. Stage 1 is over. Now stage 2, what will develop? Interesting, very interesting. Now, there will be, first structure that will develop will be cavernous sinus. Now exactly, see this position. This segment was very important. This is the segment of the primary head vein which is lying medial to trigeminal ganglion. Now the same primary head vein where my finger is pointing, medial to trigeminal ganglion, will develop into cavernous sinus. So this structure will develop into, now here, this will develop into cavernous sinus. At this time, there will be one vein which is coming from oral cavity and the face. That vein which is coming, which is draining the blood from oral cavity and face, will be known as primitive maxillary vein. So this will lie just syphilic to, this is syphilic, this is caudal, syphilic to the trigeminal ganglion. So let me draw here, this is the vein. And this vein which is draining will be known as the primitive maxillary vein, which will drain the blood from the maxilla, oral cavity and the face. Therefore, as cavernous sinus has developed, after this primary head vein will slowly regress in size. It will slowly disappear, not down. At this point, at this juncture, the anterior dural stem, there will be connection between anterior and middle dural stem. So the connection of the primary head vein, which is present between anterior dural stem and middle dural stem, this much section will lead to the development of transverse sinus. This is how transverse sinus will develop. The portion of primary head vein between anterior dural stem and middle dural stem, this much portion will lead to development of transverse sinus. Another very important sinus. Portion of the primary head vein between middle dural stem and posterior dural stem, this much portion will lead to development of, it will lead to development of sigmoid sinus. This is how sigmoid sinus will also develop. And the portion which is left now, middle dural stem, will lead to development of, now this middle dural stem will lead to development of superior petrosal sinus. So these are the main venous sinuses which have developed. Please note down. Now, what about this primitive maxillary vein? This primitive maxillary vein will be left over, or it will be developed into the ophthalmic vein. If you recollect the ophthalmic vein which is draining in the cavernous sinus, so primitive maxillary vein will develop into ophthalmic vein. Therefore, now after completing this development, there will be various venous channels, various venous sinuses which are left from the superolateral wall of the forebrain. This is the last stage in the development of primary head vein. Various venous sinuses which are located on the superolateral part of the forebrain will lead to development of sagittal plexus of veins. And these sagittal plexus of veins will be connecting the right and left side, right and left superolateral hemispheres. And therefore they will develop into superior sagittal vein, straight sinus, and the great cerebral vein. These three veins, superior sagittal sinus, straight sinus, and great cerebral vein, will be developed from sagittal plexus of veins. Here we finish the primary head vein.